In this video, I'll be explaining calculus using Roblox Studio. You've probably played an obby or speedrun where your character moves faster on ramps, or accelerates out of nowhere. Ever wondered how that motion is calculated? That's calculus, and calculus is really just about understanding change and accumulation. Okay, quick pause. Before we dive into speed and distance, I want to share something that helped me really get calculus, even before thinking about motion. Let's say we have four parts. Each part is a rectangle with a height of h and a width of 1. So the total area of all four rectangles is just 4h. Visually, this is like graphing a constant value. Each rectangle has the same height h. As we move along the x-axis, the height doesn't change. It's flat, y equals h. Now let's think about integration. Integration means adding things up, so if we integrate, we're just adding up the areas of these rectangles as we go. The first part gives us area h. After two rectangles, we've got 2h. After three, it's 3h, and so on. So when we plot the total area as we go, we get a straight line. That's a linear equation. We can write that as ax equals h times x, where x is the number of rectangles we've added so far. If we integrate again, meaning we start adding up those total areas, we'd get a curve, a parabola. But let's stick to the linear part for now. So remember, integration just gives us the total so far. At each step, we're accumulating more and more. Now, what if we go in reverse? We take the derivative of this linear area function. The height of the graph now represents total area. So the difference between consecutive points, say, for h minus 3h, gives us how much the area increased. That's just h. To get the rate of change, we divide that by the change in x, but since each rectangle is 1 unit wide, that's just dividing by 1. So we end up with h. That's what the derivative tells us, how fast the total is growing at each step. And as you can see, we've recovered the original height, the original function. We're back to graphing a constant again. This makes sense because the slope or rate of change of a line stays the same for every point. Derivatives and integrals are inverse functions. To see this, let's look at this parabola. At each point, we can find the slope or the rate of change for each point. Right now we approximated the function using lines. If we were to graph the rate of change at each point, we'd get back to a linear equation. This makes sense because at the first slope, we'd get h, for the second slope, we'd get 2h, etc., so we get back to a line. And to integrate this line, we just add the values as we move along the axis. And we're back at the parabola. This ties directly into motion. If we go back to the graph of a constant, our position on the x-axis is our time, while our height is our speed. The total area is our distance. Think of speed as your rate of change. If you multiply the speed by time, you get the distance. That's what integration is doing, adding up all the little bits of distance over time. On the flip side, if you divide distance by time, you get your average speed. That's like taking a derivative. Now, everything we've talked about so far used nice, clean rectangles with a width of 1. That's easy to see. But what if we want to be more precise? What if the change along the x-axis isn't 1, but something much smaller? That's where infinitesimals come in. Instead of rectangles that are 1 unit wide, we imagine rectangles that are really, really tiny. Like, almost zero. Let's call the width dx. It's a tiny sliver along the x-axis. To keep it simple, let's just use our equation for a parabola. Let's call it f of x this time. Last time we took two consecutive points and found the rate of change between them. This time we're just going to do the same thing, except that our change in x is now very very small, approaching zero. To express this idea precisely, we use a limit. This just means that we look at what happens as the change in x gets closer and closer to zero. Now what about our change in y or the height? We can express that formally using this. This is essentially just what we did earlier with 4h minus 3h. Then all we have to do is divide by the change in x, and there you go, the formal definition of a derivative. Now what about integrals? We know that the height for each rectangle is f of x, or just our y. And our width is dx, which is infinitely small, so each tiny rectangle has an area of f of x times dx. The d, by the way, just stands for tiny change. To get the total area, we just add up all these little pieces, every tiny bit from start to end. That's what integration does. It's just the continuous version of what we did before, adding up rectangles, but now with infinitely many, infinitely thin slices. That's integration in the continuous world. The integral symbol just means we add up all the stuff from this point to that point, or a to b. If we differentiate an integral, we just get back the original function. That's the fundamental theorem of calculus. By the way, d over dx is just a fancy way to say take the derivative with respect to x. In other words, d over dx asks, how fast is something changing as x changes? We're saying, what's the rate of change of f of x, anyways, so yeah, that's it. So now, you can look up how to actually do derivatives and integrals, because this video only explained the concept. Also, yes, this is a calculus video disguised as a Roblox video. You can click on this video on the screen now to know why your computer sucks at math. Also, you can send me video ideas in the comments to help me out, because the school year just started, THX.